You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where Francesca shows us when to use which machine learning algorithms and how to boot on the Visual Designer on the next episode of the AI Show special from Microsoft Ignite. See you then. Hello and welcome to this special edition of the AI Show. Coming to you from Microsoft Ignite, I've got my dear friend and colleague, Francesca Lazzari. How are you doing, my friend?
Very good, thank you.
Fantastic. So look, here's the problem I have. Anytime I hear about machine learning, I look it up and then there's like 50 bajillion algorithms and I don't even know how to start. So why don't you help us out? Tell us a little bit about machine learning algorithms, what they are, and then how we know how to select them when we have a problem.
Absolutely. And again, this is a question that customers ask me all the time, so it's not just you, Seth.
Okay, good.
And also for this, we wrote an algorithm cheat sheet
that
you can find on Docs. So again, everything starts with a question.
Okay.
I always tell my customers, machine learning, deep learning, AI is very fancy, but if you don't have a business question and if you don't have the right data, then it's very hard to do this.
Right.
So you start with a question and it's also, what do you want to do? For example, let me actually enlarge this. Okay, for example, you want to predict between different categories, you want to predict between two categories. So it depends on what you do. There is a different algorithm for you that is ready in what is called now Azure Machine Learning Designer.
I see.
And this is a module, meaning that it's a specific algorithm that is going to help you to use your data. So it's going to learn from your data to give you back the answer.
That's awesome. So as I'm looking at this, the first thing I have to do with anything machine learning related is I have to be specific about what I'm trying to solve. Which is like, now that I think about it as a programmer, it's like, yeah, you can't just be like, hey, write a program. You have to know what the outcome or objectives are. And here what you're saying is, depending on what you want to do, there's a set of algorithms that will help you do that.
Yes.
So this is awesome. We'll get a link to this in the show so people can go and look at that.
Absolutely.
The second thing you said that you threw out kind of fast, and I was like, wait a minute, is there is a way to use these inside something called Azure Machine Learning, the Visual Designer. Can you tell us about that?
Yes. Azure Machine Learning Designer is the new version of Azure Machine Learning Studio. And I have to say it's an amazing tool that really is able to unify teams with people of different technical backgrounds.
I see.
A data scientist, I work in teams where I have to work with a data architect, business expert, software engineers. And using Designer really allows us to see the hand-to-hand process, so how you can build a hand-to-hand machine learning solution, and also have a look at what other people are doing. And you can have people who can code using the Designer. There are some modules called execute R script, execute Python script, but there are also other modules that are already created there for you. And the people who, for example, don't want to code too much, they can still build their own machine learning solution.
Awesome. Using can you design. Show us?
Of course.
All
so
right.
Here I have a Designer. So as you can see, I already created an experiment for my customers. This is a time series forecasting for sales. So you just need to input your data, and here you have a bunch of options in terms of a data set. These were the data set that I linked from a blob storage. And then if you scroll down, you can see that you get the different options in terms of data input and output, data transformation, feature selection, model training, and then the most important part,
which
is
the part where we, the
machine learning algorithm. Like for example, if you notice here, I use a Boost decision tree regression, which is a type of regression, because my time series forecasting model was performing very well. I was able to get a 96% accuracy using this data. And here you can train, score your model, and the nice things of Designer is really the deployment experience.
Okay.
You just need to click on run, and then immediately it's going to create for you from training a predictive experiment. And the nice things of the predictive experiments is also that it's going to have two different modules, the web service input and the web service output. And then let me show you here. Let me zoom out. Here you have the web service input and here the web service output, but the experiment is exactly the same. Final thing that is exactly as important as the other things is how are you going to consume this model? Again, machine learning AI is beautiful, but how are you actually going to get the most important value. So here there is just the endpoint sections where you can see from the predictive experiment, you can get some sample in C#, Python, R. These are just sample code that you can use to consume your model. And here, as you can see, there are some primary keys and the REST endpoint. This is the URI, and you just need to copy these, insert these in your application, and your AI application is going to consume your machine learning model that you build in Designer.
This is awesome. I mean, basically, you come up with a question, you look at the algorithm cheat sheet, you drag your data in, you wire stuff up, try it out, see if it works, it'll tell you if it's good, and then you can actually release it as an endpoint to consume.
Exactly.
This is pretty amazing. This is very exciting. Thank you so much for showing this.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching. We've learned about what machine learning algorithms to use. We've also learned how to use a visual designer to actually implement it and use it. Thank you so much again.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching this episode of the AI Show, coming to you special from Microsoft Ignite. We'll see you next time. Take care.